everyone, Crafting Vicky here with you, and today I want to make some backgrounds for some flowish journal. I'm doing a swap with Betsy Doodle. I will be putting down in the description box below the link to her channel. She's just such an amazing lady, and I get a lot of inspiration from her. And so she agreed to participate in a flowish journal swap with me, and I want to make a cover to go for that. And because I keep running out of covers, I figured I might as well do a few. So what I did is I used two envelopes back to back and stitch it all around. And so now I've got a blank canvas to play with. And then I had some envelope that had already been cut out, and one that I cut out because basically what happens is, depending on how they've been cut, like in this case, it's been cut through there. So it's kind of, it's awkward to do a stitch and reuse those envelopes compared to these, where it's the smaller edge that has been cut. So I decided to open them up and to do just one side, because basically the other side is kind of cute and somebody can use it. So I figured I would use that, and then, you know, I can send that in happy mail to somebody. So this is what I'm thinking. I've pulled out some paints that I'm thinking of using. I also received this week, I don't know when this is gonna air, but anyway, I purchased some stuff on AliExpress just for the fun of it, to be able to use them as a stamping thing. And this is to put a baby's bowl to get it to stick. So it has these kind of has the shape on it. So I don't know if it's gonna stamp well, but I thought it might be fun to try doing that and to stamp with this. The other thing that I receive is this. It's a little doily, and on this side it has raised flowers and stuff, and you know how I love playing with silicone, so that's why I got to this idea. So we will try using this and we will see what happens to this. I'm gonna leave the zooming, because I've got a feeling you guys might not see much if I zoom too in. So we will get going with this. It's gonna be messy, but it should be fun. So let's just put some paint down on some stuff, and just make sure that my other camera is as the furthest, so this way if I put my head in the midst of it, I can use the other camera. So let's just have some messy good time. Let the kid out of me and just play, and see what happens with this. So that's gonna be messy. Kind of dry this off a bit. Maybe I can have three going at one time. So I kind of want them done quickly. Just nothing fancy. Just, you know, backgrounds and stuff that I can use to send as a journal cover. Just having fun, you know. cover these up. And then I can do some stenciling and maybe add some book paper on them. I'm still using the same brush, and I don't care. Sending paint everywhere. Okay, so dry this off a bit. Add some book paper, book page. Probably putting paint all over my nose. This is going to go that way, so just this way. Actually, put the envelope upside down. I just saw the logo. It's right there. Oh well. Doesn't matter. One assigned. Let's do the same thing with this one. So now that they've got Liquitex gloss medium on them, I don't want them to stick together. Whoops. Okay, so let's do that one and put it right side up. This one, a little more book page. I should do more backgrounds, but then again, I keep telling you guys this and I don't do it, so this is why now I'm trying to make a few, so this way I will have some when I want to make something with them. Okay, so that is that. Now pretty sure that in my bin of stuff I must have something that I could use. Have some napkins. I need to make more of this paper. I keep wanting to do some so that I can share it with you guys. Got some of that. Okay, so let's go back to this one. A little bit more stuff to it. This was going to have texture as well. Like that. Fun. And maybe something like this in this corner. Right. And then let's get this one. Okay, so put this one aside. Now let's go back to this. So I'm thinking that maybe I want to do some sprays. I think I'll use my Black Pearl pearlized water. This is a homemade spray that I did. It's all shimmery, so I love that. Okay. And for this one, maybe the purple Lindy's stamp. Spray. And at the same time, you see we're getting some stuff on the other one. So we're getting it messy and having a base, which is fun. Maybe use this one. It's another Lindy spray. Now, for this one, let's dry this off a bit. Really love this. Turning out like a messy fun, and it's what's great with this is I have no clue what it's gonna end up looking like. Okay, so let's find some stamps that we can use. Got this one. It's a big number. It's from Paper Artsy. It's one of my new sets. Oh, there it is. And archival ink. It's fun. I don't know when at the end if there's anything like of that that's going to show, but still, it's fun. And then maybe that one. Got to remember to put in the flow journal some of these liners, if I can think about it. Okay, I like that. And then maybe to finish this one off, got my PBO studio, the paints that are all shimmery. I love those, so maybe this would be fun. thing here in the corner. Okay, so I think this side is pretty much done. So I'll move on to the other one, let this dry, and then we can do the other side of that paper and then get it to dry completely. While we're working on something else. So this one is pretty good already. So let's do some stamping again. Time I think I'm going to use some scripts. What happens. Oh, it's really cool. Did you see that, guys? Look, is that cool? What's fun is you don't really have much control over it because you don't know how it's gonna pick up the ink, but I really love this. So my point in purchasing this was that you can really use all kinds of stuff, even stuff that you would never think of using. I love looking now for silicone things with different ideas in mind, you know? And let's do more of the circles maybe with this. It's not working so much. This is a silicone mat that you would put under a hot plate. Yep, messy fun, loving it. Okay, so let's move on to this last one. For this one, I'm thinking of using that image from the set that I showed you. Oh, I love her. I purchased this one to use that stamp, but never used it yet. I love it. Let's use this crisscross piece. Use this shelf opener. Okay, so this one to me is finished. This back is already done, so I'll hang this to dry. And let's get going on the back of the other ones. So this one, let's get going on this back. I just realized that I didn't do any stenciling on the other ones. Oh well. It's okay. They don't have to be all the same, right? Got some blue on the other side, but I don't really care. Some violet. Okay, so I'll let this dry. I'll start doing something on this one. Fun just getting messy and just playing. Even though this video will probably end up being quite long. Okay, let's get back to this one. Now I think I want to glue some stuff down. Thank you.
upside down. That's the side of it. Okay, let's bring this one out. Just that way. pizza. I think for this one, I might not do a lot of painting. I might actually leave the thing blank. I kind of like the white underneath this. Okay, that was not expected, but a fun thing. So let's put this one back, and now we're at the step where we put some sprays on top. So maybe use a green from Lindy spray. I'm gonna do some stenciling, but in white, because it's pretty dark, that one, already. So let's do some stenciling using some white paint. It's not wet anymore. Okay, so a bit of stenciling, not stenciling, but stepping. And I think this will be all done. So maybe this one. So I think this is done. This is one side and this is the other side. I'm really liking how it turned out. So this will go off to dry. Bring this one back, and for this one, some stenciling with this PBO paint. That one. I still have a bit of paint here, so let's use it up on this. Hoping my head is not in it, in the frame too much. This time I'll use this little stamp. It's a Tim Holtz one. This is one side, and this is the other messy side. So put that aside, dry. Okay, now we've got this little piece that just needs a bit more to be called done. that's it. Okay, so I said this part I'm happy with, so I just need to work on this side, and we've got that one left, and then that's done. I really love the smell of paint. Have that I can put on there. Oh, got a paper napkin. Good colors for this. And the goal is to use up my stuff and not just hoard it.
want.
Have to fill up my Liquitex bottle again. I purchased a really big bottle and then I refill the smaller one as I'm using it up. Okay, so I think that's enough collage. I can spray a bit. Let's put this away. And put that away. Let's use my ID swap. I haven't used it in a long time. Maybe that's why I haven't used it in a long time. It looks like it's clogged. I love the colors. This is really awesome on this. Yes. Happy, happy, happy. Now, do I add something else to this? Maybe just a bit of stamping, and that will be finished as well. Actually, my dad gave me this huge stamp during Christmas time, and it's for numbers. And I suppose that it was for like phone numbers or file numbers or God knows what type of numbers. But I think it's kind of cool. And oops. This one I want to change. I don't know where he found this, but it's very cool. I love when he finds stuff for me because he really has great ideas. And he's starting to really see, he's seen me do all kinds of stuff with different mediums that have nothing to do with crafting technically. And so now he's like really on the lookout for me, so that is awesome. Okay, so that's one side and this is the other side. And I really like this. I think it's pretty cool. Oops. Just got one left. Just do a bit of stamping on. So this is it. I hope you've enjoyed watching me make a mess, and I hope it inspires you to go and make your own mess. And do give me a thumbs up if you like it. Leave comments. I love reading them. Oh my god, my hands are a mess. And yeah, I love reading them. And subscribe if you haven't already. So that's it for now. Bye, folks.